Number five, the Warrior Two. Back to some basic exercises for 3 weeks, three times per week for 4 weeks. I've added some very interesting variations to this workout to really spice it up. Don't be afraid to let your warrior spirit out just a little. Complete at least 2 days per week of light cardio training.
We want our hands about a little bit wider than shoulder width, and we want to start from a full hang perspective and then pull ourselves up so our chin will hit the bar. Okay, so that's pull up unassisted. And now we have this thing that will allow you to take some weight off your body weight. So it's some surgical tubing that is designed for a foot stirrup. So I'll show you me putting my foot in there. And then you stand on this. So what it does is it gives you help coming up for your pull up. So you still want to start at full arm extension, and you want to use your lats, which are the big muscles of the back. And so the way we start this, if you can't do pull-ups or you can't do with the assisting, we would start with the Vectra, and we would do the pull downs, which anybody can do that because we can adjust the weight all the way down to 10, 15, 20 pounds. So anybody can do that. So that's the pull-up. All right, exercise two for the warrior workout is the kettlebell deadlift. Now we're doing kettlebells this time instead of the barbell because we're gonna use lighter weight, but we're gonna be going down lower and still for the 50 repetitions. So still a good amount of repetitions, but with the kettlebells, you're able to go down lower than you can with the barbell. Because the barbell, it's gonna be set, I mean, the max weight on the barbell for the deadlifts for the warrior program is 135 pounds. So I was using 115 pounds and that's fine, but that's the maximum weight that people will go to. So once you get to there and you do your 50 reps, then that's fine. So with the kettlebell now, you can go up to, these are 35 pound kettlebells, and I don't recommend going above 44 pound kettlebells unless you feel really strong in this, because you're doing lots of high repetitions. So you want to make sure your form is perfect. So I'll do a couple straight on. I'll do some from the side so you can see the form. But the form is going to be the same. So if I have the kettlebells in my hand, I'm going to hinge at the waist. I'm going to go down straight to the floor. And so with this, we don't have to worry about a bar going over the knees, which is nice. But it does allow you to go a little bit deeper than with the bar. So this is the kettlebell deadlift. So you're gonna have your feet about the same width as the regular deadlift, maybe just a little bit narrower. And so you start with the kettlebells hanging by your side, and then you're gonna hinge at the waist, and then you're gonna go down and touch the floor with the kettlebells, and then stand up. So again, the same thing is true. It's gonna work the glutes, it's gonna work the low back, the mid back, the upper back, the arms and shoulders, as well as the hamstrings. So you wanna have good form, and so you'll have you'll notice you have a good grip on the kettlebell, so that'll also work your grip for the high repetitions. But this is not a fast exercise, just like the barbell deadlift. It's nice and controlled, but you are going down a little bit deeper. So I'm going to turn to the side so you can see this. And so the same thing is true. I'm going to hinge and then just drop straight down. So my weight is on the middle part of my foot. As I go up and down with this, I want to keep my spine tall. And I want to keep my eyes up and my chin up as I do this movement called the kettlebell deadlift. A basic push-up. So this can be done in a variety of ways. I'm going to show the standard push-up, so my body's straight on my toes. I'm going to show the modified push-up, which will be on my knees. And then if that's too difficult for somebody, we would start you standing at a wall with a specific angle away from your feet. So we will get, you can do this exercise no matter what level of physical fitness or strength you have. So first it will be the standard push-up. So you want your hands about shoulder width apart, maybe a little bit more. And you want to keep your core tight as you go up and down. And you want to make sure you get all the way to the floor and touch your chest to the floor. So that's the standard push-up. And so you want to avoid the noodle in the low back because then you've lost your core. So now I will demonstrate the modified push-up. So from my knees, And I'm still keeping my knees through my hips, through my shoulders, nice and straight. And then just same thing, going down, touching, pressing back up.
Jump squats. This is a pretty standard movement. Hinge at the waist to engage the glutes and then get whatever knee bend you feel appropriate and then explode off the ground. The main issue with this is landing softly with appropriate form. With the concentric phase as well as the eccentric phase, the knees need to stay in alignment over the feet. This is not so much a plyometric exercise as it is a landing, absorbing, and then exploding back off the ground.
Now we're moving on to some core exercises. So the first one is an exciting one. It's called the abdominal crunches. And this again has many variations. So if putting your feet in these loops and using the Bosu ball doesn't work for you, there's lots of adaptations we can do. I'll show you the basic atomic crunch with my hands on the floor, and that gives me complete stability over my upper body. And so by design, you'd like to keep when we're going to be on the horizontal in a push-up position with our feet in these loops. And so these are called bandit loops. And so they're an adjustable strap loop that you can do a lot of different things for, but the easiest things we use these for is putting our feet in to do some core exercises. So I'm going to get on the floor, get my instep in the loops, and then get out to a push-up position, and I'll show you the first one, which is the basic atomic crunch. And my goal in doing this is trying to keep my butt or my hips the same level as my shoulders. And so I'm going to be swinging my knees to the side and bringing my knees up, and with a pendulum bringing them back and bringing them up the other side. So we'll see how good I can do this. And then the second way I'm going to show you is using the Bosu ball for instability, which makes it a lot more challenging to do this exercise. So you'd like the straps about shin height, mid-shin height for the bottom part of the strap. And so I'm going to get up into a push-up position here. And then hopefully my butt's level with my shoulders. And I want to bring my knees up to the side, bring it back, bring them up to the side. So tremendous core exercise, upper body exercise, and arms and shoulders. So you try to get a nice pendulum swing going at first. If you have difficulty with this exercise, it's because your core is not strong enough. So again, like I said, there's many things we can do to modify this with sliders and things like that before we even get on the ropes. So here we do it again, a few reps. Okay, so that's the basic move. And so this throws a completely different dynamic into it because we're using a Bosu ball upside down, which has no stability to it. So it's going to be moving around and takes a lot more effort on the person with their core to keep this engaged. So you can see that this is not a very easy exercise. And so if you start off with this, you're starting off with the most challenging one of this. So if you work into it, you will increase your strength, your core strength as you do this, and your balance and your upper body strength. Let me try a few more reps. Okay. That does it for the atomic crunch, hands and Bosu ball. Next exercise is called the kettlebell push press. And so the great thing about kettlebells, I think they work a lot better than dumbbells because they have what's called an offset center of gravity. So when I pick this up and bring it around, I actually don't even have to hold on to it and it can stay there just perfectly. As if I had a dumbbell, I'd have to grip it tight so it wouldn't fall out of my hand. So these have what's called an offset center of gravity. And what's great about this exercise is I'm just going to have a slight knee bend for a push press. So that's all it is. I go down a little bit, push with my legs, finish by pushing with my arms. So if you wanted to, you can do both hands at the same time. I choose not to just because my left shoulder is just a little bit funky. And so you can also use whatever weight is appropriate for which side. So I'm going to demonstrate my left side with 20 pounds. And if I wanted to do it, I could do it with 15 pounds or even 10 pounds. So again, I keep my torso tall, I can have my hand out for balance if I choose to, but just a little bit of knee bend and then finish with a press. Tremendous shoulder trap tricep exercise involves the core because you have to stabilize your torso to be able to push with your legs. So this is called the kettlebell push press. The amount of knee bend will vary, but typically you just need a couple inches to get the weight moving, and then you finish with your arm. That is the kettlebell push press. We want our hands about a little bit wider than shoulder width, and we want to start from a full hang perspective and then pull ourselves up so our chin will hit the bar. Okay, so that's pull up unassisted. And now we have this thing that will allow you to take some weight off your body weight. So it's some surgical tubing that is designed for a foot stirrup. So I'll show you me putting my foot in there. And then you stand on this. So what it does is it gives you help coming up for your pull up. So you still wanna start at full arm extension, and you want to use your lats, which are the big muscles of the back. And so the way we start this, if you can't do pull-ups or you can't do with the assisted thing, we would start with the Vectra, and we would do the pull-downs, which anybody can do that because we can adjust the weight all the way down to 10, 15, 20 pounds. So anybody can do that. So that's the pull-up.